Jasper Kujawski. Referee in charge in the ring, Mr. Dave Dunbar. Introducing first, to my right, fighting out of the red corner, wears black with silver and gold trim. Official weight, 145.4 pounds. He comes to us from Ciudad Obregón, Sonora, Mexico, and brings to the ring a professional record consisting of 27 victories, including 17 by knockout in 36 bouts. Introducing Ivan Zurdo Alvarez. Across the ring, his opponent fights out of the blue corner, wears white with gold. He tipped the scale at 146.8 pounds. He comes to us from Etobicoke, Ontario, and brings to the ring a perfect professional record of 11 victories, including 5 by knockout in 11 contests. Introducing the current NAVA welterweight champion of Canada,
gentlemen, we went through the rules earlier in the dressing room. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. Above here and above here will be considered good blows. Is there any questions from the corner? Questions from the boxers? Boxers, touch gloves now, come out at the bell. Good luck to you both.
As you take a look at the tail of the tape, Ron 3 years younger, a little bit of the edge in height. Look at those pro rounds for Alvarez. That's a big number in his favor, 211 to 49. But he wouldn't look in Perron's eyes for the stare down.
You can definitely see the experience that Alvarez has overcame. It's a big step up for him.
And we talk about different circuits. This 27 and 9 coming from Mexico is a world of difference than 27 and 9 coming from some other places. Mexico fighter, good pedigree, and a few losses there, usually no big deal.
You have a lot of fighters coming out of Mexico.
And you can start pro early. A lot of guys have a 10-fight winning streak while they're still in high school. In Mexico, you could start young very early and get that experience.
And also you could start boxing pro very early.
15, I believe it is.
That's right.
A guy 11-0, you'll say, okay, he's fighting a 27-9 guy, he's much better. But this is a Mexican, so we will see
exactly. You can see they're both feeling each other out. Kane's moving his head.
Good body shot.
Pops that straight right to the body. It lands clean. Alvarez rolls, connects with a straight right to Kane's head.
What do you think of the move of Heron turning southpaw from a distance as he skipped along the ropes? Safe there because not in close?
From a distance, it can work. When he's close, it's the same fighters. It's the same position. He just has to make sure that he's not turning himself or switching from orthodox to southpaw with Alvarez being able to counter.
You get caught on the switch if you're in too close.
And that's what is that he'll be switching from the orthodox position to the southpaw position.
Second round of eight. Ron and Alvarez. Dave Bontempo and Troy Ross with you. In Toronto. See Adonis Stevenson later. See Kaboom Rivas later. A question I have for you, Troy, with Perron is he's 11-0 with five knockouts, and you get the sense he will not be a knockout puncher. So what are the things he has to do to impress the bosses in the sport and to increase his appeal?
In order for Kane Perron to improve in the sport, he has to work on hitting his opponents. He has to make the miss, he has to make the pay. He has to box and box well using his abilities, because you can see that he does not have much power to take guys out with one punch. But the accumulations of punches is when he's able to, he might be able to take a guy out, one of his opponents.
Now we've seen very few fighters without the big pop go all that far in the sport, with some notable exceptions like Paul Anand.
That's right.
Paul was talk a good game.
He can talk a good game, and he can box a very good game. And that's with Kane. That's what he's got to do. He's not a puncher first. He's a boxer first. So that's what he has to keep on working on his skills, working on his defensive skills to keep him in the game. Keep it to prolong the life of boxing in the game and just keep on working.
I think those are some of the things you have to do. Where people say, he never loses a round.
That's
okay,
right.
I can get behind a boxer, he never loses a round. Meantime, Alvarez trying to take a round away from him here. Right hand from Alvarez, and the sneaky uppercut just missed.
Kane just put his hands up right on time to be able to block that uppercut and that hook to the head.
And a good jab to the body by Perron. Good jab by Perron as the round comes to an end.
It was a very good jab by Perron, and you can see that Alvarez was holding on to his head.
In the crowd. So here we are into round three. And Alvarez in the black trunks, 27-9. Perron, 11-0.
Close, and Kane just letting Perron just letting his hands go. But he's getting caught. He just got caught with a nice straight right.
Good body work here by Alvarez, and a nice panel shot by Perron.
Has to give himself a little bit more distance. He's fighting a little bit too close. I know Alvarez is the taller guy, but in order for him to get in, he needs to pop that jab a little bit more, just like what he just did just now. If Alvarez throws one jab, Perron should throw two, three to get himself in, to let his hands go.
And when you look at them next to each other, you would get the sense that Alvarez should be the one that would have an easier time jabbing. Yet, in this round, Perron is beating him to that.
He's beating him to that because he's throwing more than one jab. He's throwing two jabs, sometimes three jabs. And that's what he has to keep on doing in order to beat the taller fighter.
All right, now let's take a look at if you're Alvarez watching what Iran is doing here. Do you change your strategy when a guy goes southpaw and commits to it like this? Do you wait for him to come back? How do you fight it?
The best weapon with the person that's switching is just to automatically use the jab so it brings it back on level playing field.
Well, ironically, Alvarez decided to switch, and Iran went back. But now they're both southpaws. That's one way to take the southpaw style away. But the jab gets it all back on because of proximity, footwork. Why will the jab work then?
The jab will work because while you're jabbing, you're able to set up your punches and make it all clear. The jab is always an effective tool if you use it correctly. Nice jab to the body by Kane. And you can see that Kane is just waiting for Alvarez to make a mistake and power on top of it.
Iran and Alvarez into round four. And you know, Troy, for Alvarez, at least there are some natural things in the cards that would make him optimistic. An eight-round fight when you've had 36, it's like basically it's like a few rounds even, and now it's a shorter fight. You win a couple of rounds early, you might be starting to sense something with the eight-round distance versus, say, 10. You're in the fight automatically.
Yes, it's a shorter distance that he's going. It's a faster pace that he has to go in order for him, with all the experience that he has, in order for him to win the fight. Tries to come up with an uppercut straight up the middle, but it just slightly missed Kane. Kane gets himself out of the way.
Said, just use the jab and try to get back on track.
Use the jab. That's, with all the switching, the jab remains the same, no matter if it's coming from a right stance or left.
Good left hook by Iran.
In.
So we close in on the halfway point. We start the second half of this fight, round five, Iran and Alvarez. So we've seen Alvarez do some big things, Troy. What do you think of the strategy for Iran of taking on a guy, a veteran of this magnitude? Just about right, or you think a little bit sooner in bringing this kind of an opponent in?
With the skills that Iran has, he's a good boxer. I don't believe that he's taken on has to put his punches together now.
Good luck.
Trying to get inside the jab. Then goes lefty again.
Heron has all the abilities to outbox Alvarez, but he has to use it. He has to use it, move his head, pop the jab. Alvarez has been landing.
His eyes.
You can see that Alvarez lands some good shot. Right now he landed a nice left hook to the head as Aaron was trying to get in.
So now you've got, now the right hand lead is open for Heron, for Alvarez there. And he didn't opt for it, but in that case, Heron was close enough on the switch, he might have been able to do it.
Yes. Switches and land that straight right.
1 minute.
You see Heron trying to work the body.
Not much on these shots now by Alvarez.
Landed on Heron, a clean hook, right hook to the head. Sort of.
Don't hold him. Let the hammer.
Right, so back and forth is Heron.
It's definitely a back and forth fight right now. It's a hard fight to score.
As we start round six, scheduled for eight, Troy, I want to get your take on the switching. It's one thing you want to do the jab, but when you see a guy switch from righty to lefty, what is he giving up? What is he trying to take away from you when he does that?
He's trying to give you different angles. He's trying to give you different angles, different looks, and different ways for him to land effective punches. Switching all the time is that your opponent gets used to you switching. So he's anticipating and he's expecting you to be switching all the time in front of him. So it almost becomes like a norm. So you do, you become a different fighter. You become a complacent fighter that's always switching in front of your opponent.
You know, when he went lefty, it opened up the right hand lead for a second, but then only for a second because it was taken back away.
It was taken back away, exactly.
With the body work.
Yes. Both fighters right now is pretty busy. Heron's a little. He's up, but both fighters right now is pretty busy on the inside. Heron has a nice straight right.
Guys have been going at it with the switching and setting a pretty good pace for this fight. But Alvarez being on the road, but the sets will have to go for broke.
Yes, he'll definitely have to go for broke. He'll have to pick up the pace a lot more. He has been landing some clean, effective shots, some big shots on Heron.
Now we're seeing some of the little tricks for Heron on the inside. slipping some shots. And showing some pretty good elusiveness.
You see that Huron's trying to pick it up as much as possible. But here, this is where the experience comes in on Alvarez. He's been there before, he's done rounds before, so that's where you can see the experience and him going the, going the distance and the long rounds. At the end of that fight, end of that round, with a little grazing right hook.
So sometimes it's not better late than never, because they're going to call you on it.
That's right.
Dave Blood Tempo, Troy Ross, our producer Frank Belmont, Omani Productions crew in Toronto with you. First of a nice night of boxing lined up.
Nice night of boxing, Dave. And you see Alvarez come up the middle with a nice uppercut to Huron's head.
Jab and a right hand, and a little sense of urgency creeping over Alvarez.
Yes. Alvarez is starting to pick up the pace a little bit more. And it's a close fight. Huron's got to do the exact same thing. He's got to pick up the pace as well. And cannot leave it in the judge's hands.
Let him go.
And you just don't know.
No, you do not know.
Good right hand by Alvarez. I mean, if you're Huron, you're figuring, I'll get a decision here if it's close.
Yeah.
But you don't know exactly what they're seeing.
You don't know exactly what they see. So you have to make sure you can't leave it in the judge's hands. You got to make it definitive. You know that you could come out with the being victorious with your hand held at the end of the fight.
Let him go. Get free with.
Alvarez lands that lead right hand we talked about in that southpaw style.
Okay, now what the head? Go home. Let him go.
Watch both of these guys go southpaw. It's like the formula. That's really good. And now
you can see Alvarez just lands a straight right on Huron. You see that he's did get hurt at that time. He's holding on.
So this has been a good round for him. Alvarez, as he buckles his opponent, takes one coming in, but this is one of Alvarez's most aggressive rounds.
He has to be aggressive right now. He has Huron moving back. He has him hurt. Here comes Huron.
Final round. Huron and Alvarez. Fight was originally scheduled for 10, moved down to 8. Initially, we thought that might favor Alvarez because, like, you're getting a couple of a push on some rounds on the road. Based on his momentum now, maybe he would wish it would be longer.
Yes, with the experience and the rounds underneath Alvarez, it definitely favors him a longer duration of a fight.
That's something how a guy just finds himself suddenly in the middle of the fight. All of a sudden, round 5 starts to come to you.
He's definitely pushing the action.
But bear in mind that Ron put a lot of early rounds in the back, regardless of how Alvarez looks now.
And that's always the case with the younger fighter. The less experience coming off of the amateur career, they haven't passed their pace. It's still a ways to go in the round, and Alvarez is being very the aggressor that's pushing the fight, while Huron backpedals tried to land.
See some blood now for Peron.
Alvarez
is a street fight. He's beating him up now.
Yes, Alvarez keeps on walking Peron down, working, hitting with nice, effective body punches. And then coming up to the head with chopping hooks.
Brown is really enjoying this fight. As we've had a nice pace, and Alvarez did not come here to be the opponent.
It's a very good action fight right now.
Good right-hand lead that we talked about for Alvarez. Nails him again. For Alvarez, rounds 7 and round 8 are very good ones for him. If you're rooting for him, the question is, can you find 3 other ones?
Peron is working at the same time. The same with the body. You can hear the crowd roaring.
Gentlemen, baru saja Anda saksikan ronde demi ronde duel antara Ken Heron versus Ivan Alvarez. Anda menyaksikan tadi bagaimana kepercayaan diri Ivan Alvarez untuk bisa meraih kemenangan dalam duel kali ini yang langsung mengepalkan tangan. Kita lihat bersama-sama Munigera, Bung Eki Selatan, Perhatian Sport One, selebrasinya begitu yakin ya. Karena memang kalau kita saksikan saja wajah dari Ken Heron ini bengkak. Terkena pukulan dari Ivan Alvarez. Bung Nigara, penilaian Anda, Bung, penampilan dari Ivan Alvarez kali ini.
Ya, tadi sebelum baru ronde pertama, saya dengan Bung Hengkis sudah bicara bahwa
cepat.
Ya, Alvarez, ya, pertandingan diduga bisa cepat dan Alvarez bisa memenangkan pertarungan. Kasat mata kita melihat memang Alvarez bisa mendominasi. Tapi jangan lupa, ya, ada hometown advantage ya. Nah, ini juga yang jadi persoalan gitu. Nah, dan sekali lagi saya nggak bosan mengatakan bahwa di tinju pro ini terjadi demokrasi yang sesungguhnya. Meskipun dirugikan, ya nggak ada marahnya juga gitu. Jadi hometown advantage ini yang membuat, nah ini kita lihat bagaimana satu straight yang telat ya. Hanya saja tidak mengenai dagu tapi mengenai hidung sehingga tidak terjatuh, tergoyah, terus sekali lagi hook kita lihat masuk begitu. Jadi kasat mata kami yakin bahwa, atau saya yakin bahwa Alvarez akan menangkan pertarungan.
Ya, kita lihat dalam tayangan ulang kembali Bung Hengki. Datang ini dia salah satu upaya yang dilakukan oleh Ivan Alvarez, menyudutkan sang lawan dan memberikan hujaman pukulan. Kita dengarkan terlebih dahulu sepertinya. Rick announcer akan mengumumkan hasil dari pertandingan kali ini.
So they will share in the adulation. Here we go.
All right, fans, let's hear it once again for these two warriors. Ladies and gentlemen, at the end of 8 rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge Hayes scores this contest 76-76. Judge Marlinsky scores it 78-74 in favor of Alvarez. And Judge Kuchowski scores this contest 76-76. This bout is a majority draw.
Crowd not happy, and that's basically like a win for Alvarez to do that on the road.
Sport One, Anda sudah mendengarkan tadi angka-angka yang diberikan oleh Dewan Juri dan inilah kita lihat, declare a draw. Jadi memang hasil berakhir dengan imbang dalam duel kali ini. Bung Nigara, kita tahu bahwa memang keputusan mutlak bagi Dewan Juri untuk memberikan penilaian apapun hasilnya. Walaupun tadi kita sudah katakan kasat mata, memang Ivan Alvarez berhasil meraih kemenangan harusnya dalam duel kali ini. Mungkin nanti kita bahas mengenai home advantage, karena home advantage ini juga bisa menjadi satu faktor yang memberikan keuntungan atau advantage tersendiri terhadap Adonis Stevenson. Kita